Located on MSDN, the Cloud Design Patterns page is a collection of guidance, including topics and patterns, to help you design your cloud applications. Currently, there are 24 design patterns and 10 guidance topics. The way you will locate these is by expanding the design patterns section and the guidance section. For someone who's new to this document, you can either read it here online on the MSDN website. You could download the book in PDF format to read on your e-reader of choice, or you can order the paperback book from Amazon.com, which you can have printed out or made available to you in Kindle version for your reading. If you do choose to use the MSDN site, the way you will navigate is you will start at the problem areas in the cloud. These are some of the common problems that you'll see discussed when talking about cloud applications. How do you design? How do you handle asynchronous messaging? How do you handle monitoring of cloud applications, applications that aren't on-premise? What about scalability and performance and resiliency? And the most important one, what about security? For each of these problem areas, you can click on one. Let's try resiliency. You can see a little bit of a brief description and some patterns that'll help you out when considering this. So for purposes of resiliency, we can look into a pattern such as the retry pattern. If we click on that, it'll take us to the pattern page. Each page is broken down similar to how you'll see it broken down in this course, by problem, solution, introduction to the pattern, and then some issues, considerations, and most importantly, an example in the context of Azure. It's very important to remember that these patterns aren't exclusive to Azure. These are not unique to Azure, and they're not required for you to implement in Azure. These are very common cloud patterns, and even though they may give you an example in Azure, this is pretty much generalized for all cloud platforms or all distributed or shared compute platforms. There are 24 design patterns currently available, ranging from things like the competing consumers pattern, sometimes known as asynchronous messaging, to CQRS, which is a very popular pattern. Then you have federated identity, which you probably have seen implemented by other providers so many times. But if you ever wanted to understand what federated identity or identity providers are, you can read this pattern. Even to things like the leader election pattern or the priority queue pattern. And some of the patterns we'll discuss, such as the retry pattern and the valet key and sharding patterns. If you're done reading the design patterns and problem areas in a cloud, you can also read the guidance topics. The guidance topics are a little bit higher level than patterns, and they go into a specific area. So for example, data partitioning. In the data partitioning guidance, we talk about why we would partition the data, how we design partitions, which is one of the most popular topics when talking about partition stores or even NoSQL stores, strategies for partitioning, and how these horizontal partitioning or vertical partitioning strategies work. So you can see that you have a lot of information here. You can learn a lot about the patterns, but you can also learn much more higher level architectural concepts. Even after you worked in the Azure platform for years, you'll still find yourself coming back to this document to learn more and more about different patterns or to go deeper into a pattern. One example is someone who's worked on the Azure platform for a long time, like to go into design patterns. And anytime I implement a pattern, many times as an architect, I have to justify the pattern. So for example, I may want to implement the valet key pattern. Now with the valet key pattern, I can use the problem and solutions paragraphs to actually help explain it to a customer why I am implementing this pattern. For example, if they say, okay, why would we implement this pattern? What are the weaknesses with this pattern? I have all of this information at my fingertips, so I don't have to memorize this or know it from heart. I can always go back to this document and source this information. It also helps me prepare a better argument for using the pattern as opposed to, in the case of Valet Key, using a web server as a direct file host. I have information here to help me validate and legitimize my argument as opposed to trying to come up with arguments off the cuff or come up with very casual arguments. So this document is available to you on MSDN. The link is in the course. And if you want to print some materials for around your office, infographic documents are available. These infographs talk about different things in Azure, but most importantly, they have one infographic that covers every single pattern that's currently available in this MSDN article. Now you can download this and send it to your favorite printer and have them print out a poster. It's a great poster to print off in your office and have hung up just so you can refer back to these patterns again and again.